Hello everyone, I am Avinash Pawar. Today we are going to study English subject of class 9, second story and the second part, The Adventure of Toto. In this story, narrator's grandfather had a zoo. He had a great liking for animals, so he had a tortoise, a pair of rabbit, a tame squirrel and a goat. He bought a monkey baby from Tonga Diver and named it Toto. Toto was very mischievous, and that's why grandmother did not like Toto, but Toto was finally accepted by grandmother. When Toto was finally accepted by grandmother, he was given a comfortable home in the stable. Stable is a place where animal used to live, where he had a companion, the family donkey Nana. So Nana is the name of donkey, but Toto and Nana could not become friends, because Toto used to tease Nana by fast biting on her long ears with the sharp little teeth. Even Nana got fed up Toto. Toto and Nana could not become friends because Toto was naughty and wicked and could not stay still for long. So how does Toto takes a bath? Toto takes a bath in a tub of warm water. He tests the temperature with his hand and then gradually step into the bath. First one foot, then the other, until he was into the water up to his neck. Then he applies the soap as well. As a monkey are good at imitating others, so Toto has learned proper steps of bathing while watching the narrators doing the same. When the water become cold, he would get out and run as quickly as he could to the kitchen fire in order to dry himself. If anyone laughed at him during this performance, Toto's feeling would be hurt and he would refuse to go on with his bath. One day, what happened? Toto nearly succeeded in boiling himself alive. A large kitten had been left on the fire boil for a tea, and Toto, finding himself with nothing better to do, decided to remove the lid. Lid means cover, and finding the water just warm enough for a bath, he got in with his head sticking out from the open kettle. This was just fine for a while. Until the water began to boil, Toto then raised himself a little, but finding it cold outside, sat down again. He continued hopping up and down for some time, until grandmother's arrived. He howled him. Howled him means pulled him out, half boiled, out of the kettle. So author said that if there is a part of brain specially developed to mischief, that part was largely developed in Toto. He was always tearing things to pieces. Whenever narrator's aunt came near him, he made every effort to get hold of her dress and tear a hole in it. So there is one incident, Toto and lunchtime incident. So one day at lunchtime, a large dish of pulao stood in the center of the dining table. Toto was stuffing himself with rice. When narrator's grandmother screamed at Toto, he threw plates at grandmother and glasses of water at one of the aunt's face. When grandfather arrived, Toto picked up the dish of pulao and made his exit through window. He sat in the branches of the jackfruit tree. The dish still in his arm, he remained there all afternoon, eating slowly through the rice, determined on finishing every grain. And then in order to spite means desire to hurt, annoy or offend someone, grandmother, who had screamed at him, he threw the dish down from the tree and chattered with the delight. It broke into 100 pieces. So he became very happy when he threw that dishes and dishes broke into pieces, and then he make a sound, chattered. So here we can say that obviously Toto was not the sort of pet we could keep for long. Even grandfather realized that they were not wealthy and could not afford the frequent loss of dishes, clothes, curtain and wallpapers. So grandfather found the Tonga driver and sold the Toto back to him for only 3 rupees. So this was the story. In the story, we learned that a pet animal, Toto, name of monkey and who was very naughty. So one cannot afford a pet animal like monkey, as we keep in home as a domestic animal or we tame such animal, because their original nature is very mischievous, very naughty kind of that animal. So thank you very much for watching this video.